I'm everyone's information source. Bachelor's Ring Central and ask for cooking and household tips and the occasional date. Other people ask me to call them back at a certain time to be woken up from a nap, to meet a train, or to take their cake from the oven. And we give out hockey scores. Now, we're as prey to that awful Spanish flu as anybody. Last fall, we were always working short-staffed. 1 in 4 of us came down with the flu. But we managed to keep the phone lines open. We got help to those poor people too weak to do anything but reach an operator. Well, these days, we telephone girls are in all the magazines. They say we're the new woman, smart, independent, single. I just wish we got paid as well. On my salary, I can barely afford my room in the boarding house. And then, I have to eat.
All the skills we mastered while men were overseas, we've become breadwinners to meet our family needs. So many of our sweethearts are never coming home. We hear it all, the stoic grief, through the telephone. When finally the ceasefire broke that bloody war, that devil of a flu fought on, killing millions more. Imagine for a moment the horror we have seen. Imagine for a second going back to how it's been. Now May of 1919, living costs soar high. Pooling our resources can't damp inflation's fire. Did you hear in Winnipeg, 30,000 in the street? Commerce at a halt, workers on their feet. Walk out, you telephone girls, take every fuse. Silence at the switchboard, we'll get our message through. Singing with our brothers, we deserve a living wage. With all we sacrificed, we demand a better day.
From Lethbridge through Calgary to Edmonton, Labour Councils vote to go out on a general strike.
Many of today's evils would be done away with if we girls just had a living wage, one that covered the normal cost of living and an allowance for some of life's little comforts.
Now waitresses earn little, shop girls even less. We're walking out for all whose work is more precarious. We're walking for the child who cannot stay in school. We're walking out to signal we no longer will be fooled. We've passed the ornate mansion, gardens so pristine. Called at humble hovels no rose has ever seen. Each dwelling lost a loved one, killed by flu or war. So why this great indifference of rich towards the poor? How some could profit while death around us churned, then fold down their factories as soldiers return. No vision do they offer beyond their war machine, yet will not stretch their minds to grasp a worker's dream. Walk out, you telephone girls, take every fuse. Silence at the switchboard, we'll get our message through. Singing with our brothers, we deserve a living wage. With all we sacrificed, we demand a better day.
In June, the federal government arrests the Winnipeg strike leaders. As a response, returned soldiers organize a peaceful march. The Mounties ride in, two strikers die.
Workers are finished being starved to live and living to starve. We're not gonna stand this much longer.
A month here in Alberta, we held the picket lines at metal shops and railroads, restaurants and mines, all for the right to bargain through the union of our choice, for labor that allows us some tiny bit of joy. From Winnipeg, the news, peaceful protest brought to blows. Strikebreaker drives a streetcar, the crowd then overthrows. So Some mounted forces charge, exploding with their shots. All trust we had in others to improve a worker's lot. Now back to work we go, or surely lose our posts. It's hard to keep our spirits up with nothing to show. They'll never jail ideas, they cannot shoot our hope. And in the next election, we working people spoke. Walk at you, telephone girls, take every fuse. Silence at the switchboard, we'll get our message through. Singing with our brothers, we deserve a living wage. With all we sacrificed, we demand a better day. Demand a better day. Demand a better day.